Look at the shape of the fragments. They come from a hollow receptacle of some sort. Something at least as tall as you. Perhaps larger. Just another piece of the puzzle. Maybe when I analyze the Witchpike residue, an answer will suggest itself. Thank you, but no. I try to avoid large population centers. The temptation. You understand. I'll find some place nearby, but out of the way, where I can set up my equipment and work undisturbed. I'll send word when I have something to report. I met a clever woman who lives in the bog near Morthol. Old Mjolin's a dying breed among the Nords. A practitioner of the old magic. The locals both admire and fear her. If anyone can help me untangle the coven's ritual, it's her. Mjolin's experience with the old ways and reach magic make her ideally suited to assist me in this endeavor. She's the closest thing to an expert we're likely to find out here. At least one who doesn't want to feed our eyes to a harpy. Western Skyrim consists of three holds. Hafengar, Hjalmarch, and Karthald. Morthol is the capital of Hjalmarch. It's located southeast of Solitude, along the river Hjol. Old Mjolin lives in the marshlands nearby. The Ravenwatch has had to curtail rogue vampire clans, and put down feral blood like this before. People turning into harrow fiends, or becoming mindless harrowed. It's a nightmare. Yes, but more research is required to confirm anything. Still, from what we observed here, it appears the Harrowstorm produced three distinct results in those caught within it. It turned them into harrow fiends, or harrowed, or it simply killed them. Mjolin's experience with the old ways and reach magic make her ideally suited to assist me in this endeavor. She's the closest thing to an expert we're likely to find.
So, what did your vampire friend discover? Reach witches summoning magical storms to create feral vampires? That's horrible, but to what purpose? Well, that's the next puzzle to solve. First, we need to get this information to the Queen. Here. This was for Brondel, but it's yours now. Queen Gerhild needs to hear what we discovered at Kilcreath Temple. Hopefully that will be enough for her to get us an audience with High King Svargrim. The Queen seemed reasonable. She'll believe us. As for Svargrim, who can tell? I haven't met the man, but everything I've heard describes him as prideful, arrogant, and hard-headed. Even with the Queen's help, there's no guarantee. I'd like to knock down the palace door, grab him by the throat, and shake him until he listens. That would probably start a war, though, and Yoren specifically asked me to avoid that. For now, let's bring our evidence to Queen Gerhild. If there's anything else we need to discuss, let's get it out of the way now, before we return to Solitude. Hey, you and Fenorian came to that conclusion, not me. Still, it makes as much sense as anything. As to why, I have no idea. This connection to vampires, though, that's troubling. We should keep Fen away. A clever woman? Out here? Nords are extremely distrustful of magic, especially Nords from Western Skyrim. I'm surprised the people of Morthol tolerate her presence. If anyone can help Fen figure out the Coven's ritual, though, it would be her. Our priority remains getting an audience with High King Svargrim. We need to convince him that the Ice Reach Coven is a threat to his kingdom, and get him to help us stop them. Let's return to Solitude and present our findings to the Queen. Clever men and women are Nords with an aptitude for magic, though most use the term to refer to practitioners of the old ways. They're rare. Not the usual adepts found at the Mage's Guild. Distrust of magic runs deep in Skyrim, especially out here. Could be that the elves our ancestors fought soured our taste for magic. Or maybe there weren't enough skalds singing about wizards going to Sovngarde. Might be that Nords just prefer their natural talents. Either way, magic isn't popular here.
please, can anybody help us?
Another survivor. Meridia be praised.
Cover your mouth when you cough, please. That's not nice. Thank you.
Thank you.